guys, welcome back to our channel.
So in this video, we are going to share with you about the first parent meeting that he had with my parents.
Yeah guys, before that I would like to give you all a small episode which happened just before I could actually see your parents. I wanted to know who they are and make a rough estimate of what, how to present myself and all that.
We used to go out every weekend. So that particular weekend he was calling me out, and my brother wanted to go for a movie that weekend. So my parents decided that we were going for a movie as a family. So I told him that I won't be able to join him that weekend because I'm going out with my family. But he insisted that he should meet me, and I was like, no, this weekend I'm surely going for the movie because I personally wanted to see the movie, and also it was a family outing after a very long time. So I was excited for that, and I didn't want to go out with him that weekend. So I was completely saying no. And he said, okay, fine, you just tell me which movie you're going to and which theater. So my brother and I discussed, and we booked the tickets for that particular movie at Inox, right? Inox, an evening show or afternoon
show? Evening show, City Center.
Evening show, City Center. And exactly, there were only 5 tickets left in one single row. Like the entire row had only 5 empty seats, and we were 4 of us. So I booked the tickets for the 4 of us: me, my mom, my brother, and my dad. So only one seat was left behind. So Danton was asking me which movie was that, which screen and all that. So I told him, I had no idea that he was trying to book a ticket for the same movie. So he went online and he saw that only one ticket was remaining in the entire theater that movie, and that seat was right next to our seat. He somehow grabbed it and booked the ticket online. And he told me this late in the night, and I didn't believe him at all. I was like, no ways. The entire theater only had one free ticket, and how is it possible for you to book that? He somehow grabbed it, and then the next day I went to the theater with my family.
So I went to the mall, the City Center Mall, and then we were roaming around over there. I was watching her from a distance, and they came just on time, just about time, just like 15 minutes before the movie could start. And they walked straight into the theater, and I was just observing her from a distance, and I waited for the movie to start. Only then I stepped into the theater because it'll be a little bit dark and they won't get to see my face and all that. So I went and sat right next to, in that last seat remaining, and I think her mom told her, okay, switch with your brother immediately.
Actually, one seat was empty next to me, and I thought it was a lie and he was not going to come because the movie had already started and it was already 10 minutes. The movie was running and nobody came. So I thought it was a lie, and the seat next to me was empty. And after 10 minutes, when dark, it was all dark, right? The theater was dark. So someone came and sat next to me, and immediately my mom said, switch the seats with your brother. So my brother was sitting next to me, so I had to switch the seats and go next to my mom. And my brother came to the seat that was near the empty seat, and in the empty seat he was sitting actually. And only after switching the seats I realized that he was sitting there, and I got so shocked, I got scared, and I was, the entire movie I did not enjoy at all. I was just praying that nobody should notice him and nobody should ask anything.
The guilt was killing her. But it was a good movie. It was a Tamil movie, and her brother and me, we were laughing. We were like,
yeah,
literally
it was
falling.
A comedy movie.
Yeah, we were literally falling off our chairs, and it was so funny. And I like this actor Sandhanam a lot.
This guy didn't look at me at all. I was continuously looking at him, trying to make some eye contact, trying to like ask him something. He was not at all looking at me. He was watching the movie as if, you know, he's come for the movie only. And both my brother and him, they were like
falling on the floor and laughing.
They were rolling at the same time. Both these guys were doing the same thing.
Oh, good. We had something in common, okay.
So he enjoyed the first half of the movie. He didn't speak anything with me. And then before they could switch on the light during the interval, he got up and he ran outside.
Yeah, just then when the interval sign started to come, I just immediately escaped. Actually signaled to her to come outside, let's meet. So she actually came after some time, and
my mom didn't let me go at all. I told her I want to go to the loo and all that. They never send me alone anywhere. So they didn't let me go. And after some time, I told my dad, okay, fine, you come with me, let's go, dad. And my dad agreed, and both of us went out. And I actually wanted to take my dad because he'll go to the gents restroom, right? And I'll get some time. If I had to go out with my mom and both of us have to go to the ladies' loo and we have to come out together, so I won't get a chance to meet him. So going with dad was like, okay, it was good. So dad went to the men's restroom and I was waiting outside, and that time we quickly met and we spoke a few words.
Yeah, and actually I almost ran into a dad that was really scary. I knew him and he did not know me. He was like, excuse me and all that. I was like,
he was walking to the men's restroom and this guy cannot even wait for that time. He just came running towards me. But my dad didn't see him.
I mean, he saw me, but
he didn't know who he was, right? So he just...
Yeah,
left.
So I got to speak to her for a few minutes.
Only for a few seconds we spoke. I was shit scared.
Yeah, she ate up half my popcorn during the time. Anyway, so her father came.
He actually forced me to take a photo and all that, because wherever we go, we take pictures, right? He was like, come stand for a photo, come just a few seconds. But I was really scared because my dad was with me and I didn't even stand for a photo. So we don't have any pictures from that day.
Okay. But there were other theaters we post those pictures for you guys. And anyways, after that the movie continued, and then I had to leave again before the movie before the lights could come on, and that was the day.
Nobody noticed him. My parents, my brother, nobody noticed him. And only recently I told them that this happened and they couldn't believe it.
There were episodes with our grandpa as well, because I always keep roaming around the house, right? So I run into him as well.
Yeah, but my grandpa was sharp, right?
Yeah,
he noticed him a few times, and he'll always like accompany me whenever I walk towards the bus stop while coming back. So he was the person who used to guard me from him. He didn't know who he was, but he knew that there was one guy who was always roaming in that area, eyeing me and all that.
Sharp people.
Yeah. Okay, now coming to the most important part, his meeting with my parents.
So how did you tell your parents that I was coming home?
Yeah, I was still in college that time. One day I told my parents that I have a friend, his name is Danton. I know him for a very long time from my school days and he's a very good friend. I like him a lot, so I want to invite him home. The reason I gave was he studied in St. Bede's hostel, and now again, that time you were sailing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and in college also he was in hostel, and now he's sailing, so he never gets to eat home food. He loves to eat home food, and he really misses home food and all that. So let's invite him home and let's, you know, give him a good meal. So that was what I told my parents, and my parents were very sweet and okay with that.
Yeah, so what happened was I was in formals and all that, going to meet her parents for the first time. So her father was very sweet. He kept calling me, Sonny, Sonny, come home, come in, and all that. They were very hospitable, they were very gentle and kind. And the food was very good. Of course, Muslim...
My mom and I planned the meal. We made aloo manchurian, we made gobi manchurian, we made ghee rice, and we made chicken curry and chicken fry, and also custard. So I was actually taking good interest in the food that my mom made on that particular day, and she was very doubtful. She was telling my dad, should we really invite this boy home, and why is she suddenly asking to invite this guy alone? Like, she is having a lot of friends, there are a lot of college mates and all that, but she's never, you know, invited anybody home, especially a boy. Why is she suddenly like coming up with this invite and home meal and all that?
She's up to something, huh?
Yeah, obviously mother, right? So she judged it, and I was telling her, mom, do this like this, do this like that, this is how he likes it, this is how he likes that. So my mom was like very pissed off, and she was very, you know, doubting me so much. But my dad wasn't doubting me at all. He was like, okay, she wants to invite her friend, what's wrong in that, let her invite.
Deadass girl, you cannot.
Yeah, you should encourage children, right? Like, at least when they reach out to you, when they come to you for something, you should not deny them. Then it's gonna, you know, take them somewhere else. So my dad said, it's okay, she only wants to invite him home, right? So what's wrong in that, let him come home.
Yes, so
that day he came home, and how was your experience?
Yeah, the food was too damn good. So I went home, I just had a formal introduction, what do I do and all that. our father was into some shipping business and all that, so he knew a lot of stuff and technical terms and all that with, related to my career and everything. Then he knew some people also at the office and all that. So after that, what happened was we had a good meal and she was serving me and all that, and she was eyeing me and smiling, big smile on her face, and I was trying to act normal and decent and be the guy who, you know, the parents will approve of and all that. So I was trying to be my best, and she was like a bulb. I was laughing.
I was not even smiling. I was laughing, looking at him, because he was so nervous. He's trying to like stay composed and he's trying to be decent, eating slowly. It was so funny.
For me, they are my future in-laws. Okay, I don't know about what was running through her mind. For me, it was completely like, this is going to be my future. So this is how it has to be and all that. So I gave my best from the in-law point of view. And then what happened, she brought the chicken and came and she grabbed the chicken from her mother and she said like, I'll serve.
I know, I was acting and, a little weird because I was too excited.
She was hyper on that day and she served chicken and she said, I fried the chicken. I was like, you never fry anything. Then I asked her mother, auntie, did she fry the chicken? Yeah, my son, that's the only thing she did. Took it and put it into the oil. She didn't even bother to take it out of the oil. That's
okay, that time
chicken.
I didn't know any cooking, okay? But at least I tried to do that, right? When you came home.
Hey, come on, okay? I mean, we fry for you.
Oh, no.
Okay. Now she cooks really well and I totally enjoy
compensate
it.
Compensate for all that.
Yeah. Oh, so what's for dinner tonight?
Nothing, because we have full day of recording. No dinner tonight.
Okay, guys, so that's how it went. And then it was all friendly invitation, formal meeting. And
like,
then,
were you nervous or scared meeting my parents? Or, you know, were you okay and you really liked the atmosphere?
I liked the atmosphere. I liked your daddy. Her father was working abroad for a long time. So, he was open-minded. So,
yeah.
That was a good... he knew the world. He knows the environment, he knows the present generation and how they think. So that was a positive point for me. So I was like, okay, he seems to understand what's happening. So I thought I won't have much of a problem, because I have Muslim friends and I've been to their houses and they are very sweet people, especially when it comes to food. It's very lavish over there, rich and lavish, I would say. So so when I went to her house also, they were very hospitable, and the food was again a plus point, and I totally enjoyed it. So my first opinion over there was, they are fantastic people and I won't have a problem in the future. That was all that was running through my mind. So I don't think it'll be trouble now that I've met them. You know, once you meet people, you can't immediately. It's hard to make a friend into an enemy, right?
But my parents didn't, you know, ask me anything after that. I think my mom asked me something. I'm not sure. She asked me, hey, who's that boy and what's happening and all that. Especially because he was so handsome. They refused to believe that he was just a friend. So I told her, nothing, ma, he's just a friend and all that. But my dad didn't ask anything. So that episode was just over, you know, it was just a breeze.